Hi, my name is Rafael. I am the application specialist with FARO Technologies, and this is the Blink. The Blink is incredibly easy to use, designed with simplicity in mind. Let's walk through the steps to get you started and take your first scan. First, you're gonna wanna make sure that all of your batteries are fully charged before going anywhere. Second, if you haven't yet downloaded the Stream app on your mobile device, go ahead and use the QR code to download it and install it. With the Stream app open, also make sure that you log into your Sphere XG account. Now, if you do not have an XG account, contact your workspace administrator. So first, let's set up the tripod. Let's also make sure that the quick release is attached. Let's grab the Blink, mount that on the tripod, lock it in place. Open the compartment and place one of our batteries inside, making sure that the lid is closed. We can power on the Blink by pressing and holding the power button for at least 1 second. Once this is booted up, we can grab our QR code, our mobile device, and we can scan that QR code. That's gonna connect our mobile device to the scanner. If it doesn't do it automatically, just make sure that the blue light is completely solid. So we have confirmed that the scanner is completely on. We have downloaded the Stream app. We have logged into Sphere XG, and we have opened the Stream app. So with the Stream app open, we're gonna first make sure that our mobile device is in fact connected to the scanner. So on the top right, there's a little X, click on that. We have different options. I'm gonna select the Blink that we want to connect to. We're gonna click on the left arrow on devices, and we're gonna go ahead and click on the top left plus icon to add a project. Here, we can rename the project. It is important that you do rename it. Otherwise, if you leave it as something else, it can override existing projects. So just rename it using any naming convention that we want. We can also click on Take New Photo. That will assign a little thumbnail to that project, easier to identify, and use current location to apply longitude and latitude coordinates. We're gonna click on Create, and we are now ready to begin scanning. On the bottom right, there is a play button. When you press that, the scanner rotates and it digitizes reality. So as you can see, once the scan has been completed, you get a ring. This is a guided feedback. This is a tool to let you know how much coverage you have to be able to register the data together. Blue indicates you are in range. If the ring turns yellow, you have moved into a suboptimal range, and red means you're completely too far and risk data quality. Picking up the scanner and moving it, you can see it is tracking you via the Stream app. And again, just keep an eye on that guided feedback. So once you've completed all of your scans, we're gonna go back to the project list. We're gonna go ahead and click on the three dots besides the project, in this case, the one that we wanna work with. And you'll notice that I get an upload icon. This allows me to then transfer the scans from the scanner to my mobile device. Once the download is complete, I can go ahead and disconnect my Wi-Fi connection to the scanner, either selecting from the drop-down menu and disconnecting it, or powering off the device. I can then establish a good Wi-Fi connection, and I can upload that scan data to Sphere XG. Let me show you how that's done. So as you can see, the transfer has been completed. Again, disconnect the Wi-Fi from the scanner. Establish a good Wi-Fi connection. And swiping left on the same project, clicking on upload allows me to upload that to Sphere XG. SphereXU is gonna basically process the data, register it, and it's gonna allow me to have a fully processed, workable point cloud for me to download when I get back into the office. Blink makes reality capture simple. It's easy to set up and simple to use, helping you to quickly capture data, review it, and share it with whoever needs to see it.